मेरे ऑडियंस मेंबर्स, यू आर पनौती, यू आर पापी एंड यू आर पप्पू. व्हाट इफ आई कॉल यू दिस ड्यूरिंग एन आर्गुमेंट? व्हाट इफ आई सिट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू एंड टेल यू दैट यू आर जस्ट बैड लक, बैड ओमेन, यू आर गुड फॉर नथिंग एंड दैट यू आर स्टैंडिंग फॉर समथिंग व्हिच इज वेल जस्ट नॉट लेट्स से गुड इन फेथ. Would that argument per se, or would that point which I'm trying to make actually hold any water? Today in this video, ladies and gentlemen, we will break down exactly what's wrong with Indian politics and why you, as an Indian citizen, should worry about this and care about this and ask for change.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours.
Love yours.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing, no such thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Pranay Bhalla show. My point with this video today is going to be, well, it's quite simple. It is going to be demanding us, the audience members, to self-reflect as citizens of India. But the question is, why has it come down to this? The first part is, what happened in the recent Cricket World Cup? My heart is still broken over that, but my heart broke even further when I saw this video from Rahul Gandhi.
Achcha bhala hamare ladke wahan pe World Cup jeet jate.
In this video, Rahul Gandhi allegedly, well, I have to say that for legal purposes, allegedly calls Narendra Modi a Panauti person, which means bad luck. Did this really hold any water? Not really. People cheered, people laughed, people made headlines with that. It was an ad hominem argument, something we've discussed in a recent video of mine. A personal attack which holds no relevance to the actual topic of the discussion, which is why it is a fallacy, it is illogical, it is a weak argument, if any argument, right? But this is not the first time we are seeing this. While Rahul Gandhi called him Panauti, we've had Mamata Banerjee called Modi Papi, and we have Modi calling both of them different things. While Rahul Gandhi has two titles, Murkho Ke Sarkar and Pappu. The problem with this is not the labeling themselves. The problem is why these labelings even take place. Why do these political party leaders always have name calling, labeling and fear mongering as part of their big manifesto or agenda to market themselves in vote back politics? And the answer is, well, perhaps a bit self-reflective for us, the Indian citizens. You see, if they thought we are smart individuals of this country, that didn't take place. It would have been a completely policy-based discussion. They would have come forward and said, the centre has these policies which we disagree with, or the opposition would have been argued against by the centre, saying they are incompetent for these particular reasons, and there would be more structure in the marketing itself. I get it. Sometimes you want to go viral. But if every time the method of going viral is just name-calling, then we should ask ourselves, do they think we are dumb? And if we are dumb, I ask us, let's get smarter and demand for more political coherency. That's the first part. The second part is when this took place, which is the Cricket World Cup. The memes we all hear, especially leading up to the finals, was that the moment India wins the World Cup, we will have all the credit go towards our PM. It's a meme. It's a joke at the end of the day. Right, guys? But that joke does have some water, which is, yes, sometimes there is credit stealing from the opposition, the centre, and at the same point of time, the opposition does take away credit where due from the centre too. But the question is, ladies and gentlemen, why cricket? It is because in vote-back politics, they want to use that one thing which has the eyes of almost everyone in the country to garner votes, to garner support, to garner attention. Cricket is India's number one love. India has always loved cricket, and cricket has always loved India. But politicians have loved cricket far more than we imagine. From the Narendra Modi Stadium to the Indira Gandhi Stadium, the grasp or the chokehold politics has on Indian cricket is astounding. And it will continue to remain so. In this, the problem is not cricket itself. It's the fact that we, when we look at these little marketing materials go around, when we look at these politicians, use these mediums to tell us, vote for us. What are they disseminating? What are they saying? If it is something like, wo murkho ka sarkar hai, he is the leader of monkeys. Or if it's something like, he's a bad omen, he's a papi, or he's a panauti. We should tell them, we are smarter than this. As Indian citizens, give us other reasons. Give us coherency, ladies and gentlemen. Now, as we all know, we're going towards 2024, the year of the general elections. The greatest elections that India will ever have, as we all see leading up to the elections. I want to ask us to demand more every time we are given less. To ask for four fire, no reward. To ask the politicians to give us actual reasons why to vote for them and not the others, rooted in logic and facts, based in policy decision making, based in executive decision making, that we can actually look at and say, yes, I want to vote for them and I know exactly why I'm voting for them. I am not brainwashed. I don't have fear mongering over my head, which is making me make these decisions. I am not in a position where my mind is doing this simply because. With that, my video comes to an end, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you learned something because I definitely did while researching for this video. Thank you.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours.
Love yours.
No such thing as a life.